Hey man, glad to see you again. I was poking around at this location and found that murders did happen in the 1960s, which led to the place getting closed. Yeah, we were looking at the paper for the Joe's Intoxic Steiner, and it seemed like that the guy that the police caught with the murders was this guy called Zach. I don't know how to say his last name. Like I said, this place had murders and it's very haunted. I saw some really screwed stuff yesterday. I thought I saw a dead body, but it must have been the ghost of the kid. Now, Nightmare Joe tends to get active as nights go on. To what I have heard, that he is haunted by, like, 7 kids. So I could see why he is haunted. All those kids in the suit are most likely really mad. So they are walking around the building in the suit. Yeah, I never liked that thought, but I'll get over it. I'm rather excited to see this place open, because in 4 days, the attraction will be put to the test and see how scary it really is. I think it will do well, because we have an animatronic that is over 50 years old. I don't know why the suit is still around, but we found it's worth a lot of money. Oh, and if you see things in your office, it's most likely a hallucination. I heard the former cookers at Joe's and Toxic Steiner had hallucinations in the kitchen, which would be your office. That's kind of spooky, but oh well. Now, do not leave the flashlight on. Nightmare Joe hates light and likes the darkness, so you may make him mad if you leave it on. Who knows what you'll do when you got to you. Well, I gotta go. I'll talk to you later. Good night, and good luck. Thank you.